Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Today we are trying something out that hundreds of you have asked for down in the comments. We're going to see what happens when we put soda in a vacuum chamber. We're gonna try this a bunch of different ways. We're gonna put whole cans in the vacuum chamber still closed. We're gonna try warming up some cans and then putting them in the vacuum chamber. We're gonna try putting open cans in, and then we're gonna try pouring soda into a different cup and putting that in and learn all about what happens with soda in a vacuum. Let's get started. First off, we're gonna go with what I think might be the least exciting version of this experiment. We're just gonna open a can of soda, put the whole thing down into the vacuum chamber, and then pull out all the air. Go. Got our can right in the center of our vacuum chamber. Pop the top on, take out all the air. Here we go, turning on the vacuum and pulling out the air. 3, 2, 1. So far, nothing. It's not even bubbling in the can yet. Oh, now it's bubbling in the can a lot. And out of the can. And off onto the bottom of the chamber. Just pouring out. I wonder how much of the soda we'll actually manage to pull out of the can and put on the bottom of the vacuum chamber. We've lost about a quarter of it out of the can so far. Now it's just bubbling a lot. It kind of looks like it's boiling inside the can. So something is still happening. Our pressure got to about 25 inches of mercury and then leveled off for a minute. And now it is very slowly starting to pass that as it pulls all the excess gas out of our liquid. Now at some point, and we may already be at that point, it is just going to start boiling the water in the soda. Of course, it won't be heating it up. It's just that with the lower pressure, the boiling temperature of the water drops way down. Well, the bubbling is slowing down. It is still bubbling, clearly, but there's less of it. All right, let's see what happens if we turn off the vacuum. Keeps bubbling for just a minute as it is still almost a perfect vacuum inside this chamber at this point. All right, reintroducing some pressure. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, smells like soda. Just vaporized soda. All right, let's see how much of this can we've lost. So we are down to about right here. So I think we lost almost a third of the contents of this can of soda as it bubbled out of the top. Just got soda floating around at the bottom of our chamber. Now I think the real test might be to see if there is any carbonation left in this or if it's just flavored water at this point. Cheers. It's about as flat as if you'd left it open for a couple of days on the counter. There's no fizz in that. It just pulled it right out. There you go. If you really like flat soda, here's a way to make that happen very quickly. I don't recommend it. It's worse. All right, that was pretty cool. Now the next one I was gonna try was pouring some of our soda into a glass and putting that in the container. But you know what? I think it'll be more fun if I just pour it straight into our vacuum chamber with no glass in the middle getting in the way. So I'm gonna pour in like 4 cans of it and we'll see how much bubbling action we can get. Changed my mind, I'm doing more than 4. I just hope it doesn't bubble so much that it gets all the way to the top. I don't think it will. Well, we've got some bubbling action starting, that's for sure. Now we've got lots of bubbling action starting. It looks like a pot of boiling soda. Gotta admit, I thought it would get a little bit more violent than that. I thought we'd have bigger bubble action with the bubbles climbing higher and sort of sticking together, almost a foam. The pressure is still dropping a little bit. You can see we're getting slightly larger bubbles at this point. There's no longer any pressure outside of the bubbles to poke them and pop them. We now have considerably less surface bubbles. They're definitely dissipating. I think that means we've pulled most of the gas out of our soda. It's funny how once you get down to almost a complete vacuum, the bubbles really occasionally start to get way bigger. You never have huge bubbles while there's still pressure in there, but once there's no pressure, sometimes the bubbles get giant. does look like some sort of mad scientist potion, almost a glowing orange, just bubbling even though there's no heat source to it. There we go, I think we have fully depressurized these 5 cans worth of soda. So let's add the pressure back in and see what it's like. I'm guessing it's completely flat. Okay. Yeah, that's completely flat. So I guess it's more like Mountain Dew drink, not soda, just drink. If that's your thing, I guess that's fine. Not really mine. Let's move on to the next experiment. So now we know what happens if we just put a whole bunch of soda into the container once and suck all the air out. So now let's see what happens if we put a sealed can down into our chamber and pull all the air out. Will the pressure inside the can be enough to make it explode? Let's try it. Very close to a complete vacuum at this point. Not a whole lot going on that I'm seeing. We're not getting anywhere like this, so let's try something else. First thing I want to try is this same can at the same temperature, but I'm going to shake it up a lot. All right, so in theory, that should now have higher internal pressure to compete with a vacuum. Coming up on 26, still nothing. All right, not getting anywhere with this can. Let's try the next idea. The YouTube channel Action Lab did a very similar experiment recently, and they had best results when they heated up their soda in a bath of warm water. So we're gonna try that. There we have it, a nice big bowl full of hot water. I should get our soda nice and toasty. That's what everyone wants, hot soda. Oh, it budged. I don't know what that means, but it budged. Well, even with the warm soda, we are not getting much of a result. I've now tried just about everything I can think of to get this can to explode in the vacuum chamber, short of boiling it. Since that's not really what we're going for, we're gonna try something else. We're gonna switch to a different soda and see if this flavor has more carbonation in it and therefore more internal pressure than the Mountain Dew does. We're gonna combine all of our tricks together and see if we can get a good result. We're gonna heat one of these cans up in warm water. We'll shake it up a little bit and then we'll put it in our smaller vacuum chamber and see if we can finally get one of these cans to explode. Whew, the bottom just distended, so pretty sure this thing's gonna explode nicely. Wow! It was at like maybe 10 inches of mercury, nowhere near a full vacuum. Like, it escaped. It got out of the container. That's how quickly that exploded. All right. So maybe shaking it wasn't terribly necessary. Now I've got warm soda all over the place. Let's try it again with one that I don't shake that much. See if just being warm is enough with this stuff. Apparently it needs a little shaking. All right, just being warm didn't do it. Let's try shaking it a little bit, but not as much as before. I thought I didn't shake it as much as before, but apparently I shook it too much. That's kind of interesting. Look at how this broke. Just this one tiny little pinprick. Now all the pressure's gone. Like it's just full of warm, flat soda at this point, but that tiny little spot is what broke open. It actually kind of hurt my hand with how hard it hit. I'm gonna get another can, and I'm gonna shake it only, like, seriously, just kind of like a back and forth. See what that does. Just the tiniest little bit. Now let's see how this does. bottom got expanded. Still waiting for that top to blow. Boom! There it is. It stood the can back up. The can fell over when the bottom popped down, and then when it exploded, it popped back up. That's hilarious. It landed upright. All right, let's let some pressure back in. I just got lemon lime soda sprayed all over everything. This is gonna be sticky. And it's interesting to me how this breaks. So the bottom expands a lot when the pressure starts building up too much. And then what actually comes off, the top gets popped off of these cans. It just sort of tears through the sides of the metal. There you have it, soda in a vacuum chamber in a number of different ways. We used the Mountain Dew with the cans cracked open and watched it erupt out of there as the pressure dropped down. We poured a whole bunch of our orange soda down into the vacuum chamber and just watched that bubble a whole lot as we reduced the pressure. And then we tried to get our soda cans to explode while they were sealed, and we couldn't get it to work with the Mountain Dew, but I guess the lemon lime soda has more carbonation in it because when we heated that up and shook it gently, we were able to get that to explode in the vacuum chamber. I don't even know if the shaking was completely necessary. I think it just sped things up a little bit. And then on this can, I shook it and it just burst open without any vacuum pressure at all. This tiny, tiny little hole put out enough pressure that it actually hurt my hand where the jet of soda hit it. This has been a lot of fun. Thanks for joining us for this video. And remember to come gear yourself up with hats, shirts, and other cool merch at thekingofrandom.com. See you there.
Can't even handle it right now.
I'm not funny.